For billions of years, distant worlds circled distant stars in absolute silence, unseen by any eye, unknown to any mind. They existed only as mathematical possibilities, as equations scribbled on chalkboards, as dreams whispered by astronomers gazing into the void. And then, in a single moment that will echo through the history of our species, we saw one. Not as a wobble in starlight, not as a shadow crossing a distant sun, but as light itself, captured and rendered into an image that your eyes can now behold. The James Webb Space Telescope has given humanity something our ancestors could never have imagined, a photograph of another world. Pause on that for a moment. A photograph of a planet orbiting another star. This is not science fiction. This is not artistic rendering or computer simulation. This is light that traveled across the cosmos, photons that bounced off an alien atmosphere and journeyed for centuries before landing on the golden mirrors of the most sophisticated eye humanity has ever constructed. And when scientists processed that data, what emerged was undeniably, unmistakably, a world. The planet is called HIP-65426b. It orbits a young star approximately 385 light-years from Earth in the constellation Centaurus. When NASA released the images in September 2022, it marked the first time the James Webb Space Telescope had directly captured an exoplanet, not inferred its presence, not detected its shadow, but actually collected its light and transformed it into something we can see. The implications of this achievement extend far beyond a single photograph. They point toward a future where we might one day image worlds not so different from our own. But to truly appreciate what Webb has accomplished, we need to understand just how impossibly difficult this task really is. Imagine standing in New York City and trying to photograph a firefly hovering next to a lighthouse in Los Angeles. Now imagine the lighthouse is 10,000 times brighter than the firefly, and both are moving. That, roughly speaking, is what it takes to directly image an exoplanet. Stars are so overwhelmingly luminous compared to the planets that orbit them that separating the two has historically been one of astronomy's greatest challenges. Most exoplanets we know about were discovered through indirect methods, watching a star dim slightly as a planet crosses in front of it, or detecting the subtle gravitational tug a planet exerts on its host star. These techniques have been remarkably successful, revealing thousands of distant worlds in our galaxy. But they tell us relatively little about what those worlds actually look like. Direct imaging changes everything. When you capture light from the planet itself, you can analyze that light. You can break it apart into its component wavelengths. You can search for the chemical fingerprints of molecules in its atmosphere. You can begin to answer questions that have haunted humanity for millennia. What are these distant worlds made of? What are their skies like? Could any of them, perhaps, harbor life? HIP-65426b is not, it should be said, a candidate for life as we understand it. It is a gas giant, somewhere between 6 and 12 times the mass of Jupiter, with no solid surface and temperatures that would vaporize most known materials. It orbits its star at a distance roughly 100 times greater than Earth's distance from the Sun, far out in the cold reaches of its solar system. And yet, even this inhospitable world represents a profound milestone. Because if Webb can image HIP-65426b, then the question becomes, what else can it see? The telescope captured the planet using multiple instruments across different wavelengths of infrared light. The images from NIRCam, Webb's near-infrared camera, show the planet at wavelengths of 3 and 4.4 microns. The images from MIRI, the mid-infrared instrument, reveal it at 11.4 and 15.5 microns. In each frame, the planet appears as a small blob of light, positioned at a distinct angle from where its parent star would be. The star itself is blocked by a coronagraph, a specialized mask built into the instruments that suppresses starlight, allowing the much fainter planetary light to emerge. If you look closely at the images, you can see small white stars marking the location of the host star, hidden behind that mask. The planet floats nearby, finally visible after eons of cosmic obscurity. Sasha Hinckley, an astronomer at the University of Exeter who led the observations, described the moment of discovery as transformative. The data, she noted, exceeded expectations. Webb performed better than anyone had dared hope, blocking the starlight with unprecedented precision and revealing the planet with startling clarity. This was not merely a technological triumph, it was a glimpse of what the next decade of astronomy might bring. Consider the trajectory of human knowledge about exoplanets. The first confirmed detection of a planet orbiting a sun-like star came in 1995, when Michel Mayor and Didier Queloz discovered 51 Pegasi b. That world was detected through the radial velocity method by observing the wobble its gravity induced in its host star. For years, this remained our primary technique. Then came the transit method, perfected by missions like Kepler and TESS, which watched for the telltale dimming of starlight as planets passed in front of their suns. Kepler alone discovered thousands of exoplanets, revealing that our galaxy teems with worlds of every imaginable variety. Hot Jupiters, super-Earths, mini-Neptunes, planets orbiting binary stars, planets with no stars at all. But all of these discoveries shared a limitation. We were detecting planets through their effects on something else. We were seeing shadows and wobbles and gravitational signatures. We were not seeing the planets themselves. Direct imaging requires something more, a telescope powerful enough to resolve the faint glow of a planet against the overwhelming glare of its star, with instruments sensitive enough to capture light that has traveled across interstellar distances. This is precisely what Webb was designed to do. The telescope itself represents one of humanity's most ambitious engineering projects. Launched on the 25th of December 2021, after more than two decades of development and a budget that eventually exceeded $10 billion, Webb carries a primary mirror 6.5 meters in diameter, composed of 18 hexagonal segments coated in gold. It orbits the Sun at a point known as L2, roughly 1.5 million kilometers from Earth, where a tennis court-sized sunshield keeps its instruments at temperatures approaching absolute zero. This extreme cold is essential because Webb observes in infrared wavelengths, and any heat from the telescope itself would contaminate its exquisitely sensitive detectors. When President Biden unveiled the first full-color images from Webb in July 2022, the world gasped at views of deep space that surpassed anything Hubble had achieved. Nebulae bloomed with impossible detail. Galaxies from the early universe emerged from the darkness. The atmospheric composition of a distant exoplanet was revealed through spectroscopy, showing clear signatures of water vapor in its skies. But for many astronomers, the most exciting moment was yet to come. The first direct image of an exoplanet, proof that Webb could see not just ancient light from the dawn of time, but the glow of worlds orbiting nearby stars. HIP 65426b had been discovered previously, in 2017, using the SPHERE instrument on the European Southern Observatory's Very Large Telescope in Chile. Ground-based observations had already confirmed its existence and estimated its basic properties. But Webb's images offered something new: sharper resolution, broader wavelength coverage, and data that would allow scientists to characterize the planet's atmosphere in unprecedented detail. Early analysis suggests the planet is hot, with temperatures around 1,300 degrees Celsius, and surrounded by clouds of silicate particles, essentially sand suspended in an alien sky. These are not conditions hospitable to life, but they are conditions we can now study directly, measuring the chemical makeup of a world that exists in a completely different stellar system. This brings us to a question that looms over all exoplanet research, a question that has driven human curiosity since we first looked up at the stars. Are we alone? The honest answer is that we do not yet know. Nothing Webb has observed so far provides definitive evidence of life beyond Earth. But the tools to search for such evidence are now in our hands. When astronomers study an exoplanet's atmosphere, they look for biosignatures, chemical compounds that might indicate biological processes. On Earth, for example, the simultaneous presence of oxygen and methane in our atmosphere is maintained by life. Without living organisms constantly replenishing these gases, they would react with each other and disappear. If we detected a similar combination on a distant world, it would demand explanation. This is where Webb's capabilities become genuinely profound. In September 2023, the telescope turned its attention to K2O-18b, a planet roughly 8.6 times the mass of Earth, orbiting a red dwarf star 120 light-years away in the constellation Leo. Unlike HIP 65426b, this world was not directly imaged. It was observed through transit spectroscopy, analyzing starlight that passed through its atmosphere. But the results were extraordinary. Webb detected clear signatures of methane and carbon dioxide, carbon-bearing molecules that hinted at intriguing atmospheric chemistry. More provocatively, preliminary data suggested the possible presence of dimethyl sulfide, a molecule that on Earth is produced almost exclusively by living organisms, primarily by phytoplankton in the oceans. Scientists urge caution here, and it is essential that we honor their restraint. The dimethyl sulfide signal is weak and requires further confirmation. K2-18b is not Earth. It may be a Haitian world, with a hydrogen-rich atmosphere and a global ocean beneath, but the conditions on such a planet remain poorly understood. The water could be too hot to support life as we know it. The atmospheric pressure could be crushing. We are at the very beginning of understanding these worlds, and leaping to conclusions would be a disservice to the rigor that science demands. But the fact that we can even ask these questions, that we can probe the atmospheres of planets orbiting other stars for potential signs of biology, represents a transformation in what humanity is capable of knowing. There is something almost spiritual about this endeavor, though the word may seem out of place in a discussion of telescopes and spectrographs. For most of our existence, we have been confined to a single world, gazing outward at points of light we could not reach and could barely comprehend. The universe was a mystery we could admire but never penetrate. Now, piece by piece, we are pulling back the veil. We are seeing individual worlds in other solar systems. We are measuring the chemistry of their skies. We are asking whether life might exist in places we will never visit, on shores we will never walk, under stars that will never warm our skin. Webb has also pushed back the boundaries of what we thought possible in terms of cosmic chemistry. In another remarkable observation, the telescope detected polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, complex carbon-based molecules in a galaxy that existed when the universe was only about 1.5 billion years old. These molecules, found on Earth in substances like coal and petroleum, were not expected to form so early in cosmic history. Their presence suggests that the young universe was chemically richer than our models predicted, that the building blocks of complexity emerged faster than we assumed. This finding does not directly relate to exoplanets, but it speaks to the same underlying truth. The universe is more dynamic, more creative, more capable of producing intricate structures than we ever dared imagine. What happens next? The scientific community is already planning follow-up observations of K2-18b to verify or refute the tentative dimethyl sulfide detection. Webb will continue to image more exoplanets directly, building a catalog of alien worlds whose light we can study. Future missions, including the proposed Habitable Worlds Observatory, may one day image Earth-like planets orbiting sun-like stars, worlds that could, in principle, support life as we know it. The search for biosignatures will intensify, guided by ever more sophisticated instruments and ever more refined models of what alien biology might look like. But we must also sit with uncertainty, and perhaps there is wisdom in that discomfort. We do not know whether the chemical signatures we detect are products of biology or geology or atmospheric processes we have not yet understood. We are like explorers who have reached the shore of a vast ocean, able to see waves breaking in the distance but unable to discern what lies beyond the horizon. The journey ahead is long, and it will demand patience, precision, and humility. What we can say, with certainty, is that the first real image of another world marks a turning point. It is proof that worlds beyond our solar system are no longer abstractions. They are places. They have atmospheres and temperatures and compositions we can measure. They catch light from their parent stars and glow faintly against the darkness, visible now to eyes that evolved on a small blue planet circling an unremarkable yellow star in an ordinary spiral galaxy. And in that visibility lies something profound, a connection across light years, a thread of photons linking us to realms we may never touch, but can finally, truly, see. Perhaps that is enough for now. Perhaps the image itself is the message. Look, it says, the universe is full of worlds. They are out there, waiting, circling their stars in silence. And for the first time in history, we are no longer imagining them. We are watching them emerge from the darkness, one by one, as the golden eye of James Webb sweeps across the sky. What we find in the years ahead remains unknown, but the search itself has already changed us. We are a species that builds telescopes and flings them into the void, hoping to glimpse something true. And on that distant day when Webb captured the light of HIP 65426b, we succeeded. We saw another world. And nothing will ever be quite the same again.